Hello, I thought I'd make a video. Well, I was asked to make a video that is a bit of a gift guide. I'm going to do a book one separately. This is the non-book gift guide. And it's really, it's gift guide and my like position on gift giving and sort of what I've learned about how to give good presents over the years. Because I think I am quite a good present giver. But I also wanted to emphasize mostly affordable gifts and also gifts that are very easy to send, as most of us won't be around loved ones this festive season. I think it's more important than ever to have things that are very, very easy to send, low impact and thoughtful. However, I'm going to start with something ridiculous. It's the very reason people ask for a gift guide. You've probably seen this on my social media. This is my moon lamp. I bought this several weeks ago. It cost £16. I'll put the exact brand that I got in the description, and you can tap it to turn it on and then also do a more blue light, and then when it charges it goes a lovely blood moon red. It is extremely light, it's like a plasticky kind of material. It's a little more difficult to send in the post, as I said, £16, and apparently this is like a trend right now and people are getting lots of ads for moon lamps and things like that. I don't get them because they don't target me with the trends. I never know what's trendy. I find out from Sana what's trendy because Sana always knows about all the trends. Ah, my moon. It's rolling away from me. Vlogmas is really fueled by ginger cordial this year. As a rule of thumb, museum gift shops are an amazing place to find really great presents. I love using them for prints. And this is a print from the Wildlife Photographer of the Year exhibition at the Natural History Museum. I got it because it reminds me of Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. This print, this is a postcard of it, I bought this print called The Embrace and I gave it as a present to my friend Ori. But there's just like all sorts of different prints from that exhibition specifically, but oftentimes you can also find prints advertising that particular museum, or a print of something else you've seen within the museum that reminds you of someone or made you think, I would like to give them this piece of the city where I live. This whole piece. I would like to put this piece in a box. Speaking of giving pieces of the city in which you live, I got this one from the London Transport Museum in Covent Garden. This is a tube map, but made out of paint. This is a reproduction of a poster that the London Underground commissioned. They commissioned a series of artists to make paintings about the tube in some way, shape, or form. And I absolutely love this one because I like colour, I love the tube, and I like paint. Even though I haven't been on the tube for a while. Also, and I have been talking about independent businesses for, how old am I now, 29? At least 13 years. I think it's really important to support independent artists where possible this year. I'll link to some of my favourites on Etsy mostly, but also elsewhere in the description bar below, link to a range of prices as well. My friend Savannah posted the other week that the Poetry Society have been selling some of their Poems on the Underground series. These posters that you may have seen if you are on the London Underground. They have a whole range of different poems that you can pick from, and sometimes sets of six. There are different series of poems they put up at different times of year or for different themes, different major world incidents, global pandemics, etc. But they have these posters for sale for £1 plus the cost of shipping, which I think was £3.50 for me. And even better, they don't come in a massive poster tube. It's like a little cardboard obelisk. It's very light, easy to recycle, and so if you wanted to add a personal note to it before it went out to your friend or your family member or whoever it is you are sending poetry to, you could have it sent to you and then quite cheaply send it on once you've added a little note, a little something something in there about why you picked that particular poem. So that's such a great selection, and also if you felt so inclined you could also make a donation to the Poetry Society, seeing as they're doing such wonderful things, spreading poetry everywhere. A lot of the things I'm including in this very gift guide are presents that I have given and presents that I've received. Some presents that I've received that I absolutely love is when someone gives me some art that they've made. I think in the UK especially, we can be a bit shy about giving something we've made as a present because it feels or can feel a little bit presumptuous, because it feels like, especially with art, like assuming you know what they want to hang in their home, or assuming that they would want something that you've made in their home. And listen, like, think of it in the worst case scenario. They hate the artwork you send them. They get it out and hang it up when you come to visit, and they take it down when you go away. Like, that's it. That's the worst case scenario. it's absolutely fine. I mean, that's not the absolute worst case scenario. I can think of worse ones, but that's the most likely worst case scenario. What's more likely is that you'll give them a piece of your art for, say, in celebration of like your first communion or something. I think it was my first communion, and they'll still have it in their home. 12? No, how old do you need to do your first communion? 7. 22 years later. This piece of art is by my godmother, who is an artist, and this piece of art was sent to me this, well, she gave me this to me, I think, during my first communion when I was 7, but it might have been my confirmation, which, I think I was like 14, 15. Or this, which is from my friend Rosie, and is actually a postcard that she painted on, and then she wrote me a lovely letter on the back of the postcard. And this is such a great idea as well, because you can send a Christmas present or whatever holiday you celebrate, or just a December present, for the price of a postcard. Isn't that wonderful? And I love them because it feels like they're in conversation with each other, even though these two people have never met and they were made at completely different points in my life. But no, I really, really love them and I have treasured them. I'm big on framing things. I also just realised that I still have these pictures of Kaylee and me from... 7,000 years ago on the side of this picture frame. That's really funny. So say you're like, Rosianna, nice idea. I'm not going to send someone some of the art that I've made. Don't be ridiculous. Something else that I've done recently that I really have been meaning to do for such a long time is ordered loads and loads of photos being printed through Snapfish. But there are other photo printing services are available. I picked some of my favourite pictures that I've always wanted to get framed, and I've ordered lots of extra ones. So if you're my friend, you might be getting some pictures of us looking absolutely adorable. I printed off pictures that remind me of like human contact. So here's a picture of me and Sana, me stealing Sana's glasses because I miss stealing Sana's glasses. Here's me and Dodie dressed up as Maria from West Side Story and Mary Poppins, with matching ribbons from Paper Chase, and Jasmine just there in the background. There's just like so many pictures of things that I wanted to have physical copies of for ages, and then have thought, actually, like, which of my friends would like a copy of this picture? And in some cases you could also, there are so many different things you could do with pictures. You could frame it. This isn't a present, this is just mine. Of, say, your gorgeous friend Lex. Look at how lovely they look. Standing among the bougainvillea in Corfu. Just such a great picture. And this in a year where we haven't seen each other, where we haven't, well, Lex and I have seen each other, but where many of us haven't been around each other, it's nice to just have a Lex in your home. You should all actually get this picture of Lex specifically printed and give it as a gift and put it in this exact frame. It's kind of like giving a little reminder of being loved and being cared for. And for me, I printed off a lot of pictures from this year to remind me that this year hasn't all been lost, that there are so many moments from this year that I just think of with such joy and tenderness, really, of just tremendous friendship, and that I'm really, really grateful for. So print off pictures that will make your friends cry, and you can, yeah, you can frame them, you can include them in cards, you can include several between a little piece of artwork you've made. I still have a couple of things that my friends made me over the years. My friend Georgia made me a little book with pictures from us at uni. I think when I can't remember if it was for my 21st birthday or was when I left to do my year abroad in the US. I think it was when I left to do my year abroad in the US. And it's such a wonderful collection of pictures, and they were all just like printed out from her computer, but I still have it. And she wrote little notes on a bunch of them, and like inside jokes and like pictures of people I fancied and stuff, like all the good stuff. And then my friend Ella gave me a massive card for my 18th birthday, I think, also with pictures of us like over the years. And I remember making my friend Ali, I think for her 16th birthday, I want to say, I got an old book from a charity shop, and I put pictures in it of us, and I did like artwork, and I put little quotations in it, and just spent loads of time on it to make it something really special. And I think I may have even done the thing where you cut out a bit of the book and you put something else inside of it, but I can't remember. But really there you see like the thought and the time, and like, here is this not relic, here is this artifact of our friendship, that I so badly want to celebrate, or that my friends wanted to celebrate and give to me. Like, it's all in the story there, you know, guys. Another angle I take when I am gift giving is what has been helpful to me and what could be helpful to the person I am giving a gift to. And something that came up a lot when I was sort of like looking around my home and sort of gathering objects for this video was tarot, because tarot for me has been such a useful tool, especially when my head is feeling so unclear, to sort of identify what it is I'm feeling, what it is I'm responding to, because it's like a visual prompt or it's a thematic prompt. Also, the act of like looking and spending time with tarot cards is me consciously putting aside time to see how I'm doing, to like check in with how I'm doing. And when I'm doing readings with and for friends, it's the spur of a wonderful conversation, often talking about things that are sometimes difficult to bring up, like ambitions and fears and uncertainties about where we are right now. And in this very uncertain year, like, what could be more wonderful than sort of helping someone else muddle through it? The deck that I have is the Our Tarot deck, which is by Sarah Shipman, and it has so many wonderful women through history and mythology and so on. It's just really beautifully made. There are so many tarot decks out there. Like, again, you can find them from independent shops. You can find recommended decks that people like. And I really like, if you are going to gift one, I like gifting one that comes with a little guide that tells you about the specific cards. This one tells me about like the key themes and then does history of whoever's featured on the card and then ends with several question prompts. But there are also lots of websites online that can help you read the cards. And also, I think when you're giving it, like, it's absolutely valid to say, don't feel like you need to be constrained by looking at the specific definitions, as it were, or interpretations of the card. Just respond to it as you would like to respond to it. I think it's such a wonderful conversation starter, and also this like reflection point. And it's just quite exciting and fun to get tarot cards as a gift. Just after first lockdown, I asked people if there were projects that they'd worked on or things that they've been doing that they were proud of. And one of the responses I got was from someone who'd set up a website called Not on the West End, from people who were working or hoping to work in the theatre industry who were currently out of work because of the pandemic, and who'd had to pivot to other small businesses and just other little projects. It's a really great website, and I'll again link it in the description bar below. But I was looking through all the different products and services being sold, and I found these wonderful earrings and many other ones from this little company called Luggle. And what I love about these, other than just like the beautiful designs, and I've already given them as like birthday presents, so I bought, I think, 4 or 5 different designs, and I gave them as birthday presents to a couple of people and then hung on to some to give as Christmas presents. What I love about them is that they have the story there, like, and it's even more meaningful if I give them to someone who works in the arts or who loves theatre, for instance, and say a little bit about where they come from, because it's extra meaningful to them. And I think that gift giving is often about making connections, whether that's a connection between you and the person you're giving the gift to, or a connection between them and something else in the world, another person who made that gift, an industry that they love, an experience that they loved. Just being able to connect people to one another, especially in such a disconnected, fractured year. And I also think the holidays, which can feel like a really disconnected, fractured time, especially when you're like, for instance, in your late 20s, and it's just, Christmas is frankly a different experience than it ever was, and it can feel confusing. Like, why don't I feel the way that I feel like I'm supposed to feel at this time? So I'm a big fan of like writing a little note when you give a gift, or if you're seeing someone in person, explaining to them why you chose it for them, because I think it gives the gift, and it also gives that extra moment of connection to it. The other website I want to mention is Made 51, which is from UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency, and it features work made by refugee artisans, including Christmas decorations. So I just ordered several Christmas decorations from refugees in all sorts of different places. Made 51 doesn't just sell Christmas ornaments, it also sells home decor and so on. But what I really love about it is that in these stories, you see the whole range of refugee experience. You see refugees who've been displaced very far from their home countries, and also refugees who have later been able to return. And that's just powerful and saddening, and also really wonderful that refugees benefit financially, basically, from the sale of these. So yes, that's my little pitch for Made 51 as well. I need more. I was born in the year 1991. I am very much a millennial, and what kind of millennial would I be if I didn't include plants in my gift-giving idea roundup? Plants are such wonderful gifts. This pancake plant was originally a tiny baby pancake plant that was propagated by Sana from her pancake plants. I'm just gonna keep saying the word pancake plant, and now I really want pancakes. Oh, that was such a mistake. But before she left me forever, she gave me a little baby pancake plant in a little baby pot that I had, and now it is just growing and growing. This is the second time that I've repotted it. And also, as many of us are home so much of the time, plants are getting so much better care than they ever would. Like, when I used to travel all the time, back in the old days, back in January, many of my plants wouldn't be as thriving as they are right now. But now my plants thrive, and what's nice is you can give a plant, whether it's a cutting of one of your own or a plant that you've bought, a little one and then a little pot, and it can be something that they can take care of. Give them responsibility for Christmas. And then for the final section of this gift-giving extravaganza, I've been thinking a lot about, again, what has made this year different and things that people have enjoyed doing this year, whether that's been like arts and crafts or puzzles or letter writing. Lex got me some very fancy writing paper from Papier for my birthday that has my name and the everything, so that I look like a very fancy writing lady. You can also get things like custom wax seals or wax seals with someone's initial on them. There's all sorts of ways that you can create either like a fun writing kit or just give them something that notes how much you love them writing to you, to encourage them to write more letters to you, or just something thoughtful and lovely and a bit special. I think that often when we talk about things being like, oh, a bit special, a bit of a treat, often it goes into the sort of beauty category, but I'm really big on stationery. I love a little bit of special stationery. My favourite stationery shop is called Choose and Keeping, and it's in central London. It's in kind of like the Covent Garden area. It's really near Seven Dials. And actually, I keep all of my writing stuff in this lovely marbled box from Choose and Keeping. On the letter writing gifting front, there's so many different directions you can go. You can make a little kit, you can get some writing paper, writing envelopes, you can go to your post office or order online some of the like limited edition range stamps to give, because they always come in these like wonderful gift sets. This is a Visions of the Universe one. I actually took this with me on my cycling trip, and it got very damp, so it's looking a little sad. And this is a video games one that I've clearly used a couple of stamps from already, but there's always like really fun different stamp options available. Another thing you can do that I've started doing recently, I went down such a rabbit hole, is buying vintage stamps or like, well, not really, I think I'm a little bit vintage. Some of these are like from the 70s. Oh my goodness. Vintage stamps that are still usable, I usually get like the Lucky Dip packs, because you always end up with some weird, random, wonderful stamps. But you can also get them along specific themes from stamp collectors and use them or provide them in a gift. Like, here's a lovely jousting knight. How delightful. Here's a Welsh Springer Spaniel. What a delight. I need to stop saying what I delight. Anyway, so you can get paper, you can get vintage stamps, you can also get vintage paper. There's people on Etsy, they go wild. People on eBay. eBay is a great place to get some stamps as well that's still usable. Then I've been trying to get better at, I'm not sure if you can quite call it calligraphy on my end, but a lot of like writing with a dip pen, dip ink, dip, I can't remember what they're called. Dip quill? Dip ink quill? whatever, one of these. I actually got this one free at an Emma screening, but they are available for sale. I love buying fun inks, and these are also a great present. So this actually, this amazing looking red ink, I got from Choose and Keeping, that very fancy, wonderful stationery shop I mentioned. I also got this one from, I think, an arts and craft shop. This is just plain old blue calligraphy ink. Classic, solid, reliable dip pens. They are called dip pens. Literally the reason I bought this green Winsor & Newton ink is because it has a frog on it. I really like the colour green, but it's got the frog, and that really pushed me over the edge. My jaw is tired, so I think that's all my non-book gift ideas. I would love to hear any other gift ideas you want to share in the comments. Like, I'm always a fan. I have received some amazing edible presents yet, and I don't mean edibles. I received some cookies very recently from Sara, fair enough, after I asked her repeatedly to make me cookies. And also Lena's been doing loads of cooking and baking, and she made me millionaire shortbread this year that was so good, and it did not last very long. She made it for me for my birthday, and it lasted, I think, 2 days. So good. So yeah, I'm a big fan of that as well. Obviously, be very COVID safe if you're giving a gift like that, or with any gift you're giving. Follow the rules. I would love to hear about the gifts that you have loved giving and receiving, so that we can all steal each other's ideas and incorporate them into our gift giving this year. Okay, I'm going to sign off now and massage my jaw and edit this video. Bye bye.